Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to start our last chapter, data handling. So all of you, please close your books, workbooks, every book, and listen. And we have learned data handling in the last year also. But this year, we are going to study about tally marks. Okay, tally marks. I'll tell you what is tally mark. If a group of information, data is given, it will be, we can represent that data in a table. Okay, we can represent that data in a table, table format. If you are writing it in a table format, first we have to write, the first column, we have to write different items. What all items are given? That first column, we have to write different items. And in the second column, you have to put the tally marks. I will tell you that what is tally marks. Second column, you have to put tally marks. And the next column, third column, you can write the count of tally marks. So, if data is given, or if some informations are given, you can... Why you are representing it in the table format? It will be easy for you others to understand. Okay, that's why we are putting it in a table. How we will put it in a table? First, we can draw a column. In that, you have to mention the first column. You have to mention the items, different items given. And in the second column, you have to write tally marks. And the third column, you have to write count of tally marks. Okay, now... What is tally marks? Tally marks is a numbering system to find number of objects from a group of objects. I will show you one image. No need to open your book now. Please listen. Here the image is not clear. Still you can see few toys. These are toys. Here different types of toys are there. Dolls are there, vehicles are there, then many things are there. So if you want to, boats, many things are there. Planes, all are there. So if you want to mention, if you want to record this item in a table, first what you have to write? Different items. First we have to write the names of different items. So for example, here the toys are there. So car, cycle, like that, different items you can write. After that, tally marks. So I already told you, it's a numbering system. How we will write tally marks? Tally marks are vertical lines like this. Like this, vertical lines. About this, I will tell you. After that, count of tally marks. This is the way we have to represent the data in a table. Now, tally marks. If in tally marks, if we are drawing one vertical line, it represents the number one. Okay. Like that, if you are drawing two tally marks, it represents two. If you are drawing three tally marks, it represents
three.
Like that, if you are drawing four tally marks, it represents
four.
But to represent 5, we will use 4 vertical lines and 1 slant lines. Okay, we cannot draw 5 lines. You have to draw 4 vertical lines. After that, you cross the next line. This represents 5. Now, if you want to represent 6, what do you want to do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plus 1, 6. Okay. If you want to represent 7, how you will do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Like that. 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then how many lines after that?
3.
Now, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, if you want to represent 10.
Ma'am.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If you want to draw 5 lines, what you will do? The fifth line you will make, you have to draw a slant line. So this tally mark will record data in groups or count the number of items in groups of 5. Groups of 5 means when 5 comes, it will become a group. Next 5, it is a group. Like this, you can draw the tally marks. Okay, have you understood how we will represent? If you want to represent 12, how we will draw? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How you want to write? How you want to draw 10? 10th line. You have to cross. Okay. It is a group of, when 5 comes, you have to do like that. 5 lines together, you want to make a group. Have you all understood?
Yes.
Then, now it becomes 10, 11, 12. Now, if you want to represent 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Is it easy to draw tally marks?
Yes.
Is it easy?
Yes.
So let us do few questions. After that, you will get more idea. Everybody, open your workbook. Page number 92. Page number 92.
Okay, ma'am.
Now I am going to mute you all, and I'll unmute one by one to say answer. Page number 92. In that, you can see a table. Number of students who like different colors is given in the table. Read the table and answer the following questions. Colors is given red, blue, yellow, green. Number of students who like red, 7. Number of students who like blue, 5. Number of students who like yellow, 10. Number of students who like green, 6. This is the information given or data given. Abhinav, please unmute and read the first question.
How many students like red color?
How many
7.
Students? So which is the option?
Option C.
Option C, 7. Very good. Very good here. Now, Adhika, please unmute and read the next question.
Yes, ma'am.
Read the next question.
Which color is liked by most of the students?
Which color?
10.
Which yellow. Color? Towards 10, which is the color?
Yellow.
So, yellow color is liked by the most of the students. Very good. Okay. Very good here. Now, Aaron. Yes, unmute.
How many students like green colors?
How many students?
6.
6. Very good, dear. Option A, 6. Now, Devananda, please unmute and read the next question.
Yes, ma'am.
Question number 4.
Which of the following aspects?
Represents tally marks.
Tally marks for the number 5.
Yes.
Ma'am, option C.
Option?
C.
Very good. This represents tally mark 5. Very good. Option C goes four vertical lines and one slant line. Okay, next question to Shipna. Please unmute. After a long time, I am meeting you. Yes. Question number five. Will you read? Do you have workbook with you?
Yes, ma'am.
Question number five.
Which of the following
represents
make of
tally marks
make of
for the number tally two. Marks for the number two. Which is two. The tally marks for number two?
Ma'am, A.
Is it A? Once more, in A, how many lines are there?
Two.
Then the one cross line also is there, no dear?
Yes, and D.
D, yes. Here total three lines are there. We cannot count that. And not only that, only for number five, we will make a cross line. Four lines, after that a cross. Other lines all are like this.
Okay,
so
ma'am.
So option D. Have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Very good here. Now, next question to Yashika. Please unmute. Unmute. Question number six. Your voice is not audible to me.
Number four.
What is the number four? What is the number for tally marks? That given tally mark represents how many? Number that given four. Tally marks shows?
Four.
Four. Because four lines are there. So it represents four. Option D. Good. Very good, Yashika. Now next question to Advai. Please unmute. Unmute here. You cannot. Option. Question number seven.
Completed.
Sorry?
Two questions.
Sorry?
Completed.
Which one not completed?
Fifth
question.
Fifth question, ma'am.
Which one? Your voice is not audible. Fourth question.
Yes, ma'am.
Fourth question, you tell me the answer. Very easy question. Which of the following show represent the tally marks for number 5? Which is the correct answer?
Ma'am, C.
Sorry?
Ma'am, C.
Yes, C is the correct answer. Now read question number 7.
The data given can be arranged in the form of dash.
Dash.
Tally marks.
Table. What is that? Table. The data, I told you, no? You can write different items, tally marks, count of tally marks. So, the data given can be arranged in the form of a table. T-A-B-L-E. All of you write? The data given can be arranged in the form of a table. Keep in mind, the data given can be arranged in the form of a table. Okay, dear. Now, next question to Hanna. Please unmute. Question number 8.
We can respect item by drawing dashed lines.
What lines? What lines we are drawing? Horizontal, vertical, slant. What lines are we are drawing to record data or represent item?
Horizontal.
That horizontal lines is all are horizontal?
No.
Then what lines? Vertical. My dear, the standing lines are vertical lines. Okay. So vertical, vertical, vertical lines. So we can represent items by drawing vertical lines. These vertical lines are tally marks. Okay. All of you keep in mind, we can represent items by drawing vertical lines.
Okay.
Shifna, please turn on your video. Gauri, please unmute. Gauri, please unmute and read the next question.
Ma'am.
Question number 9.
A dash is a vertical line. Draw a
drawn.
Drawn denotes number of items.
What is the vertical line? What we are using to find the number of items? What lines we are drawing to find number of items?
Ma'am, tally marks.
Very good. Tally mark. A tally mark. All of you write along with me. TALLYMARK. Tally mark is a vertical line drawn to denote the number of items. A tally mark. TALLYMARK. Tally mark. It's a vertical line drawn to denote the number of items. TALLYMARK. Tally mark. Okay. Siddharth, please unmute and read the next question. Question number 10.
What is
written
in the first
column
of a data table?
The first column, what we will mention? I told you
items.
Very good. Items. You can write different items in the data. 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 Very good, Siddharth. Now, Lizel, please unmute and read the next question. Different items in the data. Wait, Lizel, let others to complete. You can unmute. Different items in the data. Everybody, please write. Different items in the data. Lizel, now unmute. Lizel, unmute. You cannot unmute. I'll come to you later. Bandar, please unmute.
Yes, ma'am.
It's number 11.
What is drawn in the sentence?
Second. Column of a data table. What is written in the second column of a data table? Here you can see a data table. In that, what is written in the second column? What is written in the second column? Bandhan?
Ma'am?
The second
blue
column? Sorry?
Tally marks.
Tally marks. Tally marks should be written in the second column. So tally marks. All of you write tally marks. In the second column, tally marks should be written. Good. left ear. You can mute your audio. Lysel, now can you unmute? No, now also. Okay. Now who is Naila? Please unmute. Ah. Just number 12.
What is written in the third column of a data table?
Ah. So Ma'am. Here you can see in the table what is written in the third column?
Numbers.
Numbers means? Count of tally marks means how many are there. Count of, we will count the tally marks and we will write in the last column. So you can write count of tally marks. All of you write count of tally marks. Otherwise you can, it is difficult to write, you can write numbers also, but count of tally marks is, it will be good. It would be better if you are writing count of tally marks. Count of tally marks. C-O-U-N-T. Count of tally marks. Now, Shravan, Shiva, please unmute.
Yes, ma'am.
Ah. Question number 13. You only want to tell me the answer. Complete the given table by writing the numbers. Okay. So, here, red, towards red, three vertical lines are given. It represents how many numbers? What is the number you have to write? Shravan?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the number I have to write here?
It's a question. One small.
Sorry?
No,
please. You can say question one small.
You have to write the number. You have to write here number. The tally mark represents. What number the tally mark represents, that you have to write here. So here three vertical lines are given. So it represents how many?
Three.
One more answer I need from you. Blue, how many? Under that, blue you can. Sorry?
Seven.
Once more you count. Once more you count. How many lines are there total? One, two, three, four, five. This represents groups of five. Group of five. So, seven. Okay. Now, after that, black.
Four.
Four. Okay, Shravan. Let me ask you somebody else. Very good, my dear. Now, let me ask you somebody else. Ihsan, please unmute. Unmute, my dear. Yellow. Yellow, how many?
Yellow.
Please count. Sorry? Count the number of lines. How many lines are there total? Yellow towards yellow. This one I am asking. Count the number of lines you count. Sorry?
One, two, three.
Wait, I will draw in bigger here. So it will be easy for you to draw, read. So total how many lines are there?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
My dear, only seven?
One, two.
My dear, this is one, two, three, four, five. If like this line is there, it represents group of 5. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So total here, how many is there?
9.
Oh, 9. So you can count every lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this represents 5. Listen here. 6, 7, 8, 9. So total 9. Okay. Have you understood now?
Yes.
Okay. Now, next question. Everybody should draw the tally marks. For question number 14, you have to draw tally marks. So one I will show you, one I will show you, the other four, three you have to do now itself. So maths 8. Yes, Siddharth, what do you want to say?
Ma'am, I already did that.
You have already done, very good. But for others I am asking, here 8, we have to represent 8. So 1, 2, listen here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fifth line you have to draw as cross line. Then 6, 7, 8. This is the way you have to represent 8. Now all of you draw for 4, 6, and 3. 4, 6, and 3. Now itself. Everyone. Four, six, three. Abel, Anna Rose, Adinath, please turn on your video. Adinath, to represent 4. How many lines we have to draw? Unmute. Unmute.
4 lines.
Ah, 4 vertical lines. That also you have to say. 4 vertical lines. I'll draw by different color. So, four vertical lines you have to draw. That could be like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, to represent 6, Anaros, please unmute and give me answer for the next one. To represent 6, how you want to draw 6 to represent 6? One, two, three, four. After that, 5, how you should draw? Slant line. And after that, one more vertical line. Okay, now it represents 6. Now, Hindi, it is very easy. 3. Only 3 vertical lines. Okay. The remaining questions we will discuss in the next class. Have you all understood?
Yes.
Tally marks.
Yes.
Is it easy?
Yes, ma'am.
Draw vertical lines. When 5 comes only, you have to draw a slant line. So groups of 5, there will be slant lines.
And can you send this in WhatsApp?
Yes. If you have any doubt, please check from the WhatsApp.
My senior.
Okay. So thank you, my dear children. Bye. See you next time.